What's up, cool kids? I'm Tenny Bear, and if you know anything about South African politics at all, you know that this week was the State of the Nation Address 2014 Part 2! Now the reason it's Part 2 is because we just had our president, Jacob JZ Showerhead Zuma, re-elected as president in South Africa. Now, the State of the Nation Address is a great place for politicians to show off their best of fashion and for South Africans to play our favorite drinking game, State of the Nation Address. The rules of the drinking game are actually very simple. You take a shot every time the president clears his throat,
strong,
touches his glasses, or mispronounces a word.
3,000 and 60,000.
Hashtag Sona 2014. Now, if you watch the Sona 2014 Part 2, you'll know that it played out like the third Hangover movie. Only fun if you are incredibly drunk. Platinum belt? More like platinum wasted. Now, the most exciting thing about the Sona address, which I did not watch, was when our president Jacob JZ Showerhead Zuma announced that South Africa will be moving to a new form of energy to power our great nation. Nuclear energy.
Nuclear energy.
Thinking about it, we should probably change his name to Jacob JZ Nuclear Head Zuma. That might explain the second compartment he has on the head there. Which makes sense, because you know he's got the shower head, the middle head, and that other head at the back there. Imagine what JZ would do if he got his hands on a nuclear weapon. This is Dooley Mandomzilla, the public protector.
You call yourself the public protector, eh? Protect yourself from this nuclear bomb, eh? Okay, now go fill up my swimming pool. I need to go take a swim.
But seriously though, South Africa actually did have a secret nuclear weapons campaign, complete with secret identities and hiding nuclear testing facilities under really suspicious objects. Oh, look! Here's a shack in the middle of the desert. I wonder what it could be hiding.
Convince the world that we are not playing games. That we are very serious. We would like them to fear that we do have, and that we might be mad enough to use.
South Africa signing this massive nuclear deal with Russia comes at a price tag of 111 billion rand.
South Africa actually started its nuclear weapons campaign in the 60s under the auspices of nuclear power. This was after World War II, when nuclear power essentially meant... just ask Japan. And South Africa continued with their nuclear power program until about the mid-70s, when they were about ready to blow stuff up. But Russia and America were having none of it, because only they can control the nuclear weapons in the world. Now, South Africa's nuclear weapons strategy was actually pretty simple. If someone comes at you with a pistol, you retaliate with a bigger gun. A really big gun that can make a really big boom! And so, before they got kicked out of power, they needed to get rid of all their nuclear weapons. Thus, South Africa was the very first country in the world to voluntarily give up their nuclear weapons. They'd never let nuclear weapons into the hands of darkies. What? Can nuclear power work? Yes! Yes, it can work! In fact, nuclear power is being used in 45 countries of the world currently. Of all the energy produced in France, nearly 75% of it is nuclear. In fact, France produces nuclear power so efficiently, they actually power other countries. Can nuclear energy go bad? But of course! Just ask Japan and Ukraine.
An atomic bomb burst is a chain reaction out of control.
Unfortunately, Japan never got to see that video. That being said, nuclear energy is a very cheap way of producing sustainable energy once you've got it started. For solar electric energy, there's cloudy days. For hydroelectric energy, there's droughts. Wind-powered energy, there's non-windy days. But we've got to remember that for nuclear energy, there's always the possibility of this. Until then, I will stay out of the way of Jacob JZ Nuclear Head Zuma. So until next time, cool kids, stay safe, cool kids.
jamming. We're jamming. We're jamming. We're jamming.
You know, it's got like a little bend in the middle, so that can be the nuclear head, and then we'll have the other head. You know, it's like a three-part system. It totally makes sense.